A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 24th November, Sunday, on the front page you have Fadnavis sworn in as CM after Ajit Pawar ditches uncle. So this is regarding Maharashtra government formation. So now BJP has informed the government, BJP's Devendra Fadnavis has been sworn in by Governor Bhagat Singh Koshyari as the next chief minister, along with Ajit Pawar of NCP as his deputy. So rather than Congress NCP Sena coalition being formed, it is now BJP NCP which have come together and formed the government. So this is, you can see, abrupt reversal in fortunes now for Shiv Sena chief Uddhav Thackeray. He was declared CM designate by Congress NCP Sena, and now you can see NCP chief Sharad Pawar, who has been spearheading efforts for coalition government with Shiv Sena, his nephew made a dramatic volte-face saying the decision to support Mr. Fadnavis was personal choice and not that of the party. So 49 NCP MLAs removed Mr. Ajit as a legislative party chief, saying his move was not in line with party's policies. So president's rule has been revoked now in Maharashtra, you can see. So center has revoked rule 12 of the transaction of business rules 1961, empowering itself to revoke the proclamation of president's rule in Maharashtra without prior approval of the union cabinet. So this is regarding rule 12. So there is a rule, department for from rules, which says prime minister may in any case or classes of cases permit or condone or departure from these rules to the extent he deems necessary. Means cabinet has to take the decision, but in some cases prime minister can take the decision. So that is rule 12 of transaction of business rules. So that has been used here. So an urgent meeting was held before he left for Brazil to attend BRICS summit, and you can see president's rule was imposed, and now cabinet did not meet to revoke the proclamation of the government. Rule 12 was used, and president's rule has been revoked from Maharashtra. Then on page 9 you have patients with rare diseases wait for support. So applications of about 190 patients seeking treatment aid is awaiting approval of health ministry. This is regarding this rare disease in which majority of the sufferers, of these 190 patients, are children. They're suffering from lysosomal storage disorder. So they're seeking treatment support. So this you should know about the disease also, lysosomal storage disorder support society, an organization for rare diseases in India, have been repeatedly representing the cases of these patients with such rare diseases with Union Health Ministry, but have not got a response. Non-committal response has come. On page 10 you have 11 mobile phones seized from MLA hotel. So security forces have searched the MLA hotel in Srinagar, where 32 senior leaders of regional parties were shifted as such, and 11 mobile phones have been recovered. So this is after the alleged humiliation of their families, including frisking of a 2-year-old child of a National Conference NC leader. So after that, security forces raided and 11 mobile phones were discovered. So this is like because they are in detention, they cannot have mobile phones. You can see it was said NC Vice President Omar Abdullah, it was said that 2-year-old son of Tanveer Sadiq was body searched. He was unzipped and before he was allowed to meet his father along with his mother and grandfather. So father is in detention, mother and grandfather had come with the child, and child was body searched. So that resulted in protest, after which security forces raided the hotel and hostel, and they seized mobile phones. Then this is India-US to sign industrial security pact. So a 2+2 agreement to facilitate encrypted communication will be reviewed here. So the industrial security pact, that is COMCASA, communications compatibility and security agreement. So this review will take place, and India is going to sign this with USA. So we have these 2+2 dialogue meets with USA. That means two ministers from India and two counterparts from USA. That is defense minister and external affairs minister from India and the defense secretary and secretary of home as such from USA. They have this 2+2 dialogue, four members. So this is going to be held on 18 December in USA, in Washington. So the two countries will at that time sign this industrial security annex and review the steps being taken to operationalize COMCASA. So COMCASA has already been signed, but then industrial security annex to it would be signed and review of COMCASA, what steps are being taken to operationalize it, will be seen. BECCA is another such agreement, you know, that is Basic Exchange and Cooperation Agreement for Geospatial Cooperation. So this is been discussed. This has not been signed yet. There are differences over issues of reciprocity in the exchange of geospatial information. And both sides, India and USA, are trying to resolve the differences to get it signed. Then another agreement which is there between India and USA is GSOMIA. You can see General Security of Military Information Agreement, which is said India signed with USA many years ago. So these are various defense related agreements which India and USA have signed. Then even logistics support agreement has also been signed. That is also there. And you can see we have actually moved forward. This has been stated. You can see by US Under Secretary of Defense that we have actually moved forward and in some cases actually put together some centrics. That is Combined Enterprise Regional Information Exchange System kits. So these kits facilitated encrypted communication between the navies. So that is how, you know, the defense cooperation is increasing between the two nations. Then on international page you have uneasy calm in Hong Kong ahead of polls. So around 4.1 million people are enrolled to vote in Hong Kong for 452 district council seats. An uneasy calm has settled in Hong Kong, which has been seeing protests for more than 3 months now. So it's going for elections, for local elections. And this is seen as a referendum on months of anti-government protests. Then this is US judge awards $180 million to reporter held captive by Iran. So he spent 544 days in captivity over espionage charges. So this is the compensation been awarded to him. Then you have top US diplomat questions viability of CPEC. So this is Alice Wells, US top diplomat for South and Central Asia. She says the CPEC, that is China-Pakistan Economic Corridor project, doesn't give benefit to young Pakistani people. So she strongly criticizes China's international development projects and lending practices under the Belt and Road Initiative. Then on business page, you have looking at rating agencies' methodologies. So this is what Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman says. Yesterday, we saw in news how CARE rating agency had shown that investments have dropped significantly at their lowest in 15 years. So now the government wants to see what methodologies are being used by these rating agencies to give such data, because now this is private sector data. Government data, which the government does not bring up, like the housing expenditure related data was not brought out the report because it said there are data credibility concerns. So uncomfortable data is suppressed, which is government data. And when private sector data is uncomfortable, then they want to look at methodologies used. Then you have below here, tea, an industry trapped in its legacy. So this is a news analysis on tea sector. And in UPSC mains also, there are questions asked on various sectors and tea sector has been significantly in news. So what are the changes taking place here? It says the sector is undergoing churn and the factors at play are more structural than cyclical. So when tea sector faces issues, it says it's a cyclical problem, but then there are structural concerns too. Means basic structure, the way it functions has to be modified. cyclical means ups and downs in economy continue. So na, in the sector, in tea industry also it continues. So that is called cyclical, up and down. So this is what a news analysis on Indian tea sector is being done here. So this is very, very important. Then on Sundays, you have an FAQ coverage, frequently asked questions. So these are important issues which are there, which are discussed. So first one is behind the halt on spending survey results. So this is what I just spoke of, household spending data. It was not released because it was uncomfortable data. And you can see the question which is put forth is, what are the reasons for the data for 2017-18 having been withheld? So this is you can see, it said there were data quality issues, data credibility concerns. And second is, how do consumer spending surveys help gauge demand and growth trends? So that complete detail is given here about this whole issue, which is very important. And this is, what is the push behind the strategic disinvestment? So around 2 days ago, we saw on the front page how various public sector undertakings, around 5 public sector undertakings, will have their entire stake of government being sold off, with management control also being given up. So this is a one-time initiative which will be taken and which will lead in money coming in the kitty of the government. Government says all this money will be used for social schemes. So the question here raised is, what is the push behind this strategic disinvestment move? And will the government stand on privatization of public sector units help the economy? What are the gains? So this is also an important issue. And here you have rounding up migrants. So this is regarding NRC in Assam. National Register of Citizens in Assam. Home Minister has announced NRC for all across the country. But the NRC which was conducted in Assam, what are the consequences of that? No? So this is here. The questions put up are, what are the laws in place to tackle illegal non-citizens? So now 19 lakh people have been excluded from NRC in Assam. So these are illegal non-citizens then. So what happens to them? What was the Foreigners Tribunal Order 1964? Why was the Foreigners Tribunal Order 1964 amended? So all that detail is provided here. So this act was also, tribunal order was also recently amended. So that is detailed out. Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here the first article is, infants become susceptible to measles infection earlier than thought. So this is talking about how, contrary to common notion that maternal antibodies against measles protect infants for the first six months of age, a small study involving 25 infants once again shows that antibodies from mother almost disappear by the end of 3 months. So infants become susceptible to measles infection at the end of 3 months and not at 6 months as earlier thought. World Health Organization presently recommends measles vaccination. So measles vaccination in countries like India, where measles still continue to be transmitted, is at 9 to 12 months. So that is quite late. And then in countries where there is no ongoing transmission, the first dose is much later, at 12 to 15 months, because they are not susceptible there. So this is a study which shows that children become susceptible to measles quite early. Measles antibodies from mother, they cease to function after 3 months. They disappear. And below here you have pesticide exposure among tea estate workers could affect their DNA. So this is a study being undertaken in West Bengal. So to prevent further health problem, it is said they need to take precautions. So it could have genetic changes to affecting their DNA, in the sense pesticide exposure. Here you can see the study has been undertaken and enzyme activity has been studied. Preventive measures are also given here. You can see the team warns of second-hand contact, where the families can also be exposed if the workers don't clean up properly before going home. So they need to be educated and take safety precautions, is being stated. And this is a study on showing how, why India's children are anemic. They lack in iron. So research reveals an inverse relationship between mother's education and incidence of child anemia. So if the mother is educated, child anemia is, chances are low. Then on Sundays, we also have this dispatches coverage, which is on various important international issues. So first one is, The fight to save Lahore from toxic smog. So where we suffer from air pollution here in Pakistan also, air pollution is a major problem. And Lahore High Court has been moved by teenage girls, three teenage girls, demanding action to tackle air pollution. The way we saw even in Delhi, infants had moved the Supreme Court on the issue of air pollution because it affects children the most. And this is, Brazil is caught in the US-China tech war. So US bid to get Huawei barred may not succeed as Brazil is increasingly depending on China. So this is the technological war between India, between USA and China on Huawei, the telecom company from China, which USA claims is actually a government entity of China, and government will get access to all data through this Huawei telecom company from various countries. So it wants all countries to ban Huawei from their 5G technology bidding and the process which would be initiated to allocate 5G spectrum. So Brazil, it seems, will not do that because it is highly dependent on China. It will not listen to US. And this is putting women at the center of urban planning. So a Japanese town that saw fast depopulation has arrested a trend with female-centric planning. So this is how in Tokyo, women have been put at the center of urban planning and design. And this is regarding costly onion. So in Bangladesh also, onion has become costly and government is importing onion by air to tackle the soaring prices after India also banned export of onion. Because in India also there is a shortage because crops were damaged because of rains, unseasonal rains which took place. So that affected the crops. So that is it. These were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashara.com. Thank you.